2 Corinthians 4. Tired tense. What could this be? While we are in his tent, we groan and are burdened. 2 Corinthians 5. The tent is tired. Those were the words of my friend Paul, who pastors a church in Nairobi, Kenya. Since 2015, the congregation has worshipped in a tent-like structure. Now Paul writes, our tent is worn out and it is leaking when it rains. My friend's words about their tent's structural weaknesses remind us of the Apostle Paul's words regarding the frailty of our human existence. In quotes, outwardly we are wasting away while we are in this tent. We groan and are burdened. End of quote. Though the awareness of our fragile human existence happens relatively early in life, we become more conscious of it as we age. Indeed, time picks our pockets. Boy, ain't that the truth. The vitality of youth surrenders reluctantly to the reality of aging. Our bodies, our tents, get tired. But tired tents need not equate to tired trust. Hope and heart needn't fade as we age. Therefore, we do not lose heart. The one who has made our bodies has made himself at home there through his spirit. And when this body can no longer serve us, we'll have a dwelling not subject to breaks and aches. We'll have a building from God, an eternal house in heaven. Let me read that again. There's something else there. But tired tents need not equate to tired trust. Hope and heart needn't fade as we age. Therefore, we do not lose heart. The apostle says, that's what messed me up. It's grammatically weird there. The one who has made our bodies has made himself at home there through his spirit. The one who has made our bodies has made himself at home. Okay. Living within us. How does it make you feel that Jesus resides in you by his spirit? When you find yourself groaning, how does prayer help you? Father, thank you for your continual presence. Oh, that sounds good. When I'm physically uncomfortable, help me to trust you even as I anticipate an eternal dwelling that will last forever. Amen. Love you. God bless.